Hi everyone, welcome back. I am Aysel, the in-house illustrator at Vectornator. And for this video, I have the pleasure of creating a more political piece in honor of Black History Month that just passed, but also to celebrate the always relevant movement, Black Lives Matter. A sketch is really important for this particular illustration, because we're going to play around with the negative space to give it actual meaning. But before I get to draw the person, I've decided to start with the leaves that surround them. This is the brush I made. It creates this very cool stroke that allows me to give the leaves a lot of dimension. I prefer to work with the brush-like vector pads instead of regular ones. So because Vectornator's brush is a freehand tool, I'm just following my sketch. Although you will notice that I'm not following it precisely. I'm simply going with what feels right at the moment. For the stem and vines, I've created another brush contour that tapers at both ends. And just like before, I just go for it and use my sketch as a rough guide. Along the way, I make sure to adjust the stroke width depending on the size of each leaf. These thick lines represent the vines from which the leaves stem. I thought they bring more power to the idea of becoming free and liberated from being tied down. I drew this with the same brush I had before, but with a much thicker stroke. For the last vine, I decided to change the angle of my brush, just because of how it's oriented in the composition. No detail is small enough. Now I'm selecting all my leaves, and because they are all closed shapes, I can color them by simply turning this toggle on. This is my go-to green for many of my illustrations. A lot of artists tend to have a preferred color palette, and I'm definitely one of them. Since we are focusing on color, I'm creating the background too. And I'm going to choose another one of my go-to colors, which is this purple here. Let's lower the opacity so we finally focus on the main character. Here I'm using a flat brush and I'm following my sketch. As opposed to the leaves, I'm going to be more careful when tracing the sketch underneath. The whole point of this aesthetic is to give meaning through negative space. So the shape of each corner and curve matters. I personally love this style so much. Some may consider it plain, but it's actually more complicated to convey a strong message in a simple way. One of my main inspirations for this style is Frank Miller, the artist behind the Sin City comics. His art is so clean and effective. As we close the shape of the head and neck, let's color it black. The layer is already set at 10% opacity, so I don't have to lower it for each shape that I draw. I did the same thing for the hands, which are holding onto vines, almost like moving them out of the way. With white fill turned on, I begin to create all the details in the face and hands. I'm basically adding the highlights where the light would hit the face. So on the forehead, around the eyes, the nose, mouth, chin, and ears. For the hands, it's almost like it's drawing a skeleton, but I'm just following the natural anatomy of the hand. Let's see the real effect of this style. I love it. It looks so much more powerful now. Alright, now let's make sure that the leaves are placed correctly so that some are behind and some are on top of the face. Finally, I think that the illustration looks a bit flat, so I've decided to turn the simple purple background into a gradient. I've got this gradient here in my palette, which you can also access if you download the Vectornator file in the description below. I went with two analog colors for the background, and together with the green, they create a split complementary harmony. After adjusting the gradient, here we are. Our illustration is finished. Hope you enjoyed this video and were able to follow along. Check out our other tutorials and make sure to support any local groups that fight for justice and equality.